right, hello, hello. My name is Tom, and I am here to react. Right? That's what we're doing? Yeah. I also have the window open because it's actually nice today, so if you hear children screaming, it's because there's a playground across the street, and hopefully not for more nefarious reasons. Yeah, so today I am going to be reacting to episode 1 of Heartstopper. So, full disclosure, I have in fact watched Heartstopper before, probably about a dozen times since it came out. Yeah, I don't know if you can see on the, this way, on the bookshelf behind me, I do have the full collection of Heartstopper with the Nick and Charlie novella as well. But yeah, basically, I'm obsessed and I want to talk about it on the internet. So here we are. That's what we're doing. Let's get started with episode 1 of Heartstopper, the best show ever. Spoilers, it's good. It's a good show. Yeah, okay, let's do it. Okay, here we go. Let's watch. Ta-dong! I'm gonna have to cut so much of this, it makes me sad. Now, I do just have to say that, like, the music in this show is amazing. Like, I listen to the playlist, like, every day. But yeah, Baby Queen has, like, 7,000 songs in this show, and they're all awesome, so. Like this one. Alright, so here's our protagonist, Charlie Spring, entering school. Happy to see a guy named Ben Hope. Poor Charlie. And, like, the song itself really reflects Charlie's relationship with Ben anyway, because it's saying, like, I'll go anywhere you want me. So basically, and like, it's an unrequited crush kind of song as well. So, oh, actually, can we meet up at break instead because I'm a douchebag? No, I'm sorry. At this point, we don't yet know. He could just be someone who has important business. Maybe he has a dentist appointment. We don't know.
Well, the rugby boys do, I think. I'm sure you'll get along swimmingly. Or you can just sit in silence for the rest of the year. Anyway,
well. All right, so Charlie looks very irritated, but then he sees the sunbeams that shine out of Nicholas Nelson's golden hair and golden retriever personality. And there go our lovely leaves. I do really like the way that they incorporated the animated aspects into this. I'm recording, right? Yes, okay. Yeah, it's... Hi. It's kind of crazy, like, thinking of that moment when you meet someone who's gonna end up being, like, everything to you, and they have no idea. They have no idea. They don't know. They don't know they're going to be in love. I mean, Charlie's already kind of in love, but... Okay, so I just tried to pause the video on my phone by pressing the space bar on my keyboard, which, of course, stopped the video instead. So, well done me. I'm clearly a pro. But anyway, I was attempting to pause in order to say something. What was it? Oh, I think I was going to say, it's interesting because, like, in the novels, in the... mirrored. In the graphic novels... No, it's not even mirrored. I just don't know where things are. Yeah, so in the graphic novels, like, when they first meet, Nick and Charlie, when Nick and Charlie first meet would be a better English way to say that, Charlie is kind of suspicious. Like, he keeps wondering, like, why does this guy keep saying hi to me? Is he going to bully me? Like, what's going on? So his initial mood in the novels is suspicion, whereas here, he's just, like, he's gone. The second he sees Nick... Sitting there with his puppy dog face, he's like, and I mean, same, honestly, but yeah. Okay, let's continue, and I'm not going to hit the space bar. Good.
Hey.
Oh, look, it's Ben.
Sorry about earlier. It's fine.
I love Sebastian Croft, but...
I miss your face so much.
Ben. No. Did you miss his face? Okay, and I'm going to pause again for a second to say, Ben is an interesting character. Like, I think... he genuinely does feel something for Charlie, which becomes clear later on with his behavior. But, like, yeah. Okay, anyway, let's continue.
Yeah, it was all right. You?
Yeah. Yeah, it was good. My whole family was around on Christmas Day and then...
Red flag number one, Charlie.
You're so cute.
Doesn't let you finish a sentence, just wants to kiss you and tell you you're cute. Which, I mean, cute, yeah, good to know. And here comes... unforgivable.
Still don't tell
you do not wipe Charlie Spring off of your lips. You let him stay there forever. Yeah.
Are you literally doing your homework or walking to your lessons?
I might be.
That's very chaotic.
That makes me sound way cooler than I actually am.
Do you want me to see that for you?
No, I'm good.
I can tell you the answer.
Then I won't learn.
But if you're stuck, I can just let me...
I just have to say, I love that Nick says, like, then I won't learn. Like, he genuinely, he's just that good of a person. He wants to learn. Ugh. Yeah. But yeah, this scene surprised me at first because, like, they get, Charlie's, like, really trying to, like, grab that pen out of Nick's hand. Like, let me do your homework for you. He's very, very insistent. It got more physical than I was expecting. Here comes a boy I do not love, just looking like a walking storm cloud. I think it's interesting to watch Nick during this interaction, because, like, he's looking between the two of them, like, oh shit, what's going on here? Kind of uncomfortable laughter, like, I'm going to be polite to this person I know, but why is he being a dick to Charlie?
Yeah.
All right, Nick right back to his homework. What a good student.
Fine. Obviously, it's better that she's at an all-girls school now. You know, Mr. Reed was still refusing to call her L.
Yeah, Mr. Reed's a massive transphobe.
Yeah, I have to say, like, I really admire the way that they included the information that L is trans and did it in, like, a very smooth, natural-sounding way. Like, it's not like an as-you-know-Bob sort of situation. It's just, like, completely, seamlessly, naturally integrated into the conversation, so yeah.
The one that looks like a golden retriever.
He doesn't look like a golden retriever. Okay, he does.
Even Charlie can't deny it. Yeah, the funny thing is, I've watched a bunch of people react to this, and every single one of them, when he says he looks like a golden retriever, they all say, yeah, he does. Because he does. He is the human embodiment of good boy energy. All right, here comes Mr. Charlie Spring, ready for another beautiful day of high school. No, do not meet him in the library. I know you're going to because, as previously mentioned, I've seen this a bunch of times, but you shouldn't. Ugh. Do you have a girlfriend? Poor Charlie. I hate you? Yes. Let it out, buddy. Let it out. Okay, no. Too spicy. Yep. I don't want to meet up anymore. Correct. Good. Immediate response from Ben. All the question marks. Sorry. I don't understand. For fuck's sake, we're not going to get caught. Yeah, that's what he's worried about. Don't ignore me, Charlie. Hello? Like, nope, no, not even like a second of pause between don't ignore me and hello. So this is a desperate man here. Here we have, here, we're going to pause here. Yeah, so another thing that I think they did a really good job here is kind of the very subtle inclusion of hints about Charlie's eating disorder. Because, yeah, like we have him here looking at a full bowl of cereal that has gone soggy, that he's clearly not going to eat. There's a lot of instances of him just, like, refusing food or saying he'll eat later, or, like, in one episode later on, we see him, like, open up his lunchbox and then close it again. So, yeah, they did a really good job of not being super obvious about it, but nonetheless, the signs are there, so. I love Tori.
Hypothetically, what sort of boy do you want to go out with?
One who doesn't mind people seeing us talk to each other would be nice.
Someone who's also a nerd. Or
low bar, but yeah.
Just someone I can have a laugh with. And he's nice and kind and likes being with me.
Mm-hmm. Oh, who could be behind the glass here? I have no idea. Oh, look! Someone you can have a laugh with who's nice and kind and likes being with you. Run! Run from your problems, Charlie. But I can't really watch this scene anymore without getting a little bit sad because Joe Locke, who plays Charlie, was telling the story about how, like, the first time that they, well, when they were recording this scene, like, he wanted to really give it his all. So, like, he was running, like, full on. And they had to do the shot, like, 20 times in a row. So by the end, apparently, he had to, like, sit with a bucket, like, about to vomit for a long time after that. So, props to Joe.
So, I had something I wanted to ask you. Charlie.
Great talent.
I wanted to tell
you. I'm so glad they included this moment.
I'm gay, too. And I'm in love with you. Do you want to go out with me? I want to be with you forever.
Yeah, for me, it's the I want to be with you forever that just cracks me up every time.
Aren't I a bit small and weak to be a rugby player? We're just a school team, you know. It's not that serious. So you're saying I am small and weak? Wait, no. No.
I love how Charlie just takes this opportunity to, like, mess with him. Oh, I am small and weak. Oh, you're saying I'm small and weak. Oh, yeah. But yeah, oh, look, you're having a laugh with him right now. Isn't that interesting? Someone you can have a laugh with, Charlie.
You want to be decent. You even like sports.
Oh, shut up, Harry. Everyone knows you're a twat. Hi.
Hi.
Not awkward at all. Hey, they're all clapping. Yay, he did it. Teamwork. He almost dropped it, but he caught it. Yay, good job. He's in the huddle. Way. Clapping. Happy times. So I really like in this sequence that we see him kind of being accepted by the rugby team, which does really align with what happens in the graphic novels. But, like, it kind of makes me sad because we don't really see any sign of that later. Like, this montage is the only time when it feels like Charlie is actually a part of the rugby team. Like, after this, all the rugby scenes are kind of, like, basically Harry being a dick or a literal adult man knocking Charlie down. So, yeah, anyway. See, like, I love that we see this and Charlie improving. I just wish we could see it during, like, an actual game. Thinking thoughts. Or just squinting into the sun. Hard to tell.
I said I don't want to meet up with you anymore.
Yeah, and I don't believe you.
What?
You're clearly just scared of getting caught.
Why would I
be scared? Yeah, the openly gay kid is definitely scared of getting caught being gay.
Everyone in school already knows I'm gay.
So, like, watching Sebastian Croft's acting in his face here, his expressions, let's say, it's really interesting. Like, I do think Ben is an interesting character. He's horrible, but he's interesting. Like, you can tell he's genuinely, like, surprised and hurt and angry and, like, lashing out because he doesn't know how to process his emotions or deal with the fact that he's not straight, whatever variation of not straight he may be. And so he takes it out on Charlie because Charlie is an easy target. And also, I think he does believe that if he just walks all over Charlie, Charlie is going to just, you know, take it and be with him even though he's being a complete asshole.
Would understand if you're figuring out your sexuality.
Then why are you angry at me?
I'm angry because you never even slightly cared about my feelings.
So right there, like, why are you angry at me? He actually sounds upset. Like, he genuinely doesn't get it. Like, he doesn't understand why Charlie is not just, you know, taking all his bullshit and letting him keep making out with him.
We'll never meet up when you want to, where you want to, when you feel like kissing a boy. You don't care about me at all.
Well, it's not like anyone else is going to want to go out with you, is it?
And this, like, first time I saw this, I was so mad. Like, I mean, it still makes me mad. But another point where it, and this is, a lot of this video is going to be me saying, this is how it's different from the comics. But in the comics, when Charlie says, you never cared about me at all, Ben says, that's clearly not true. And then sexually assaults him. Whereas here, he says, like, well, it's not like anybody else is going to want to go out with you, is it? And then sexually assaults him. So both are bad. But this is a bit worse.
Charlie, look, I like you, but I'm figuring stuff out. Literally, what more do you want from me?
And I think Ben is being genuine there. Like, he's going about it entirely the wrong way and has no idea what consent means. But, like, I think that's an example of him being honest. Like, he genuinely does have some kind of feelings for Charlie. They're twisted and wrong, but he has some feelings for Charlie, and he wants to continue meeting up with him, but he also doesn't want to stop being an asshole, so, yeah, what are we gonna do?
He told you to stop.
That's right, Nick.
Go on. Piss off.
I am sad that he doesn't say fuck off, but I understand. I understand why it was changed to piss off.
Sorry. You say sorry a lot. Don't say it.
I kind of want to say it.
Don't.
Honestly, that's one of my favorite interactions of theirs. And so relatable, as I too am an over-apologizer. And I love that, like, Nick makes a point of, like, touching Charlie, patting his shoulder, showing him, like, this is okay, I'm here for you. You know, I don't judge you for what just happened.
I'm that way.
Okay. Bye.
Bye.
And look back. Smiling. And then it's interesting, the colors go kind of gray, and like, I don't think it's super obvious in the show, but in the comic, that's the moment that Charlie is kind of thinking like, oh yeah, Nick is straight, nothing can come of this. So even though he was very happy about the fact that Nick saved him, he's still kind of also feeling down about the hopelessness of his situation. And here's the real queen, Olivia Colman. Yay!
Nick?
What? Yeah, it's normal.
Okay.
So normal. Thank you. Kiss. And here's my favorite shot of the entire episode. Nick's little smile. Ah, I love it. I love it so much. Okay, so that's the first episode, which I talked through pretty much all of it because I've seen it 1,000 times. But yeah, this show is fantastic, and it deserves all the good things and deserves to be renewed for a second season. So I really hope that we get that, because there's just so many, there are so many interesting things that I would love to see them explore and see what they do with those things in season two. I mean, we have the Paris trip, which is iconic. We have exploration of Charlie's, you know, mental health and eating disorder and everything like that. We also have promises of Isaac getting more of a storyline with him being aromantic and asexual, which is awesome. We need more Aroace representation. And yeah, just but at the same time, like, thinking back on the things that happen in the next volumes of the graphic novel and imagining like Joe Locke with his adorable puppy face. Well, they both have puppy faces, but his adorable face, like seeing him go through these awful things makes me very apprehensive. Like I know it will kill me a little bit inside to see him suffer through some of the things that Charlie suffers through. And Nick too, Kit Connor as Nick, like Kit, honestly, like, I think everyone in this show is amazing, but Kit Connor just blew me away. Like, he is an exceptional actor. The things that he does with his expressions, and just, you can see everything that's going on in Nick's head just broadcast in his face, in his eyes, and the little motions that he makes. So I think he's a phenomenal actor, but Joe is too. They're all fantastic. But okay, anyway, that is all. My throat is actually a little bit dry, and because I've been talking for like a solid 30 minutes, so okay, hopefully I can edit this together so it makes some sort of sense. We shall see. Maybe no one will see this because I will make a mess of it, or surprise, it turns out it wasn't recording the audio for this 33 minutes that I've been talking, so it's not going to be that much on the video because it will be trimmed down, but anyway. All right, thank you so much for watching. If indeed you have watched, which I imagine you have if you're hearing me say this, but maybe you skipped to the end. Maybe you're that person. Goodbye.